Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to Old St. Mary's Catholic Church as we remember Joseph Doorley and give worship, praise, and thanksgiving for the gift of his life. As we begin this Mass of Christian burial, would you please check to make sure that cell phones and other electronic devices are silenced at this time? Thank you. I call your attention to the hymnal that is in the pew, ritual song, and the worship aid that you received as you arrived. Please join in the singing and praying as we celebrate this funeral Mass. The opening hymn will be number 869 in the hymnal, "Here I Am, Lord," number 869. Now at this time, will you please stand and face the baptismal font?
Let us be gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Our brother Joe has died with Christ so that he may live with him in glory. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, It is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Joe, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we hear this sacred scripture readings.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to give birth and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. What profit have workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to mortals to be busied about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts, so they cannot find out from beginning to end the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to rejoice and to do well during life. Moreover, that all can eat and drink and enjoy the good of all their toil. This is a gift of God. I recognize that whatever God does will endure forever. There is no adding to it or taking from it. Thus God has done that he may revered. What is now has already been, what is to be already is. God retrieves what has gone by. The word of the Lord.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters. of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Gently you raise me and heal my weary soul. You lead me by pathways of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Though I should wander the valley of death, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. Your rod and your staff, my comfort and my hope. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. You have set me a banquet of love in the face of hatred, crowning me with love beyond my power to hold. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Surely your kindness and mercy follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of my God forevermore. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage, through all patience and teaching. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I competed well, I finished the race, I've kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, who will award me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, firstly, let me say that our love and our friendship, our prayers and our support and condolences go out to you, Nanette, and to Tom and Kathy, and to all of Tom's, all of Joe's family and friends. It's a wonderful gathering of people this morning. Please know that we share your sense of loss. There probably isn't a more comforting text in all of the Holy Scriptures than the 23rd Psalm that we heard as our psalm between the readings this morning. "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." Or as another translation reads, "The Lord is my shepherd, I have everything I need." Around and within these timeless lines is a nourishing grace that sustains us through life's difficult moments. What is it about this psalm that never lets go of us? For one thing, it reminds us that God is not distant, impersonal, or aloof. Thankfully, the person who penned these lines of this beautiful psalm had no concept as God as the man upstairs. To our great benefit, the psalmist enjoyed an intimate and deeply personal relationship with the Lord. That kind of relationship is what all of us need, especially on a day like today. When our hearts are heavy with grief, these words bring comfort. "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." This morning, as we celebrate Joe's birth into eternal life, we are surrounded and comforted by the church's funeral ritual and by the symbols that surround us. And every word and gesture of this Mass expresses our faith and our respect for this man, this disciple of Christ, Joe Doorley. Throughout the Gospels, we hear Jesus speaking of those things that should mark the life of a Christian person: humility, mercy, compassion, a longing for what is right and just, a life lived transparently, that is, genuinely, honestly, without hidden agenda. A life lived joyfully, seeking always to foster the true peace of God. The willingness to stand firm, to stay the course for what is right and true, even when it means hardship, sacrifice, ridicule, persecution. Jesus taught his disciples that these were the things that were really important, that they had ultimate value in God's eyes and in God's kingdom. And Jesus taught them this not only with his words, but also by the example of his life. Throughout his life, our brother Joe strove to do the right thing. And with a generous spirit, he showed forth the love of God, enriching the lives of so many. Just one example. The day after Joe's death, the first words his neighbor Jack Campbell said to me were, "Joe is a good guy." When my wife died, he and Annette were so good to me, so kind and supportive. With these sacred rites, we now show our gratitude for the gift of Joe's life. And we, the church, show our respect for him, a baptized and anointed child of God, this good guy. We give thanks to God for the example of your life, Joe, and we wish you a most happy reunion with your sister Patricia and all the loved ones who have gone before you. May the angels and saints lead you into God's holy, loving, and eternal presence. Joe, pray for us, even as we pray for you. Let us stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. And to each of the prayers, please respond, "Hear our prayer."
In baptism, Joe received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our brother Joe was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Joe seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Joe. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. to set. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our offering may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Joseph may be taken into the glory of your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection had dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of death might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and the saints and the whole company of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory is without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You're the source of all holiness. And we ask you to make holy these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when they had finished supper, Jesus took the cup. Once again, he gave you thanks, and giving it to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have counted us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. We pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop. Remember your servant Joseph, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Paul and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs with them to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We now pray together those words Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we might be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look then not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us share with those around us some sign of the peace of Christ. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, happy and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. We invite those of you who would like to receive communion to please come forward down these aisles. If you come down in two files and then return by the side aisles.
You shall cross the barren desert. But you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand.
Side. Know that I am with you.
that are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked tongues insult and hate you, all because of me,
Let us pray. Lord God, your Son, Jesus Christ, gave us the sacrament of his body and blood to guide us on our pilgrim way to your kingdom. May our brother Joe, who shared in the Eucharist, come to the banquet of life that Christ has prepared for all of us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Tom?
Not everyone here has a brother, but I pray if you do have a brother, you're as fortunate as I am to have Joe. And it's sort of funny because up until I was about 20 years old, I really didn't know Joe. There's about 5 years difference from us, and I was gone when he went through the high school stuff and all that, so I didn't really get to know him that well. But one of my earliest memories from Joe is he always wanted to get into the FBI. That drove him through taking college courses in accounting to get his degree, in spite of his older brother being at the same college, trying to get him derailed and do things that were more fun. Joe did stick to it, and he got his wish. Growing up in Park Forest, Joe and I and my older sister, Pat, shared the same bedroom. Kathy, who's here, was in with my parents because our grandmother had the only other bedroom. Maybe not fortunately. Eventually, she passed away, and
sorry about that.
We liked her. We did. We liked her. She's a cool lady, really. And that gave Joe and I our own room. I don't know if many of you realize this. When Joe was born, he had severe asthma. We had the doc come to the house periodically to give him these whatever kind of shots they are. Well, that's when doctors used to come to the house. And we had these trundle beds where you roll one out from under the, and I had the top bunk because I'm the older brother. And Joe would wheeze. And uh, I I'm a very light sleeper. So my other memory, other than him getting to the bureau, was I'd lean over and I'd hold his nose. And, you know, that might have contributed to his asthma attacks in the middle of the night. Now, I'm not, you can't prove it, but he did this routinely. So you'd think I'd learn. He springs up and just hits me. He didn't care where, the side of the head, you know, and then we'd start sort of discussing what just happened. My father would come through the door, and he would help Joe retaliate in kind, so. But since I turned 20, Joe's really, he's my best friend. Interesting to have your brother and your best friend, Juan. I don't deserve it, but I'm not going to turn it down. And even though he's my best friend, I'd do anything for him, even though he tried to have Nanette shoot me one day. I probably should elaborate a little bit on that. I moved away. I moved when Joe went to New York City. For some reason, a year later, I got transferred to New Hampshire, and Joe and I would see each other, you know, once a month. He would come up to New Hampshire. I would find reasons to be in New York City, and my wife Nancy loves Joe like everybody else, so she'd say, you know, Tom, you should stay there. Poor Joe. And I'm okay. And one time he came up, and Megan, my daughter, was about 3 or 4. She had a little sleepover going on, and he pulls up with a bureau car, turns the siren on, the loudspeaker, and Megan Doorley, come on out with your hands up. And had these little 3 and 4 years old running around, you know, and probably shouldn't have told that story. There's so many agents here tonight, but she loves her Uncle Joe. When I come back to Chicago periodically, I like to run the lakefront, and even though Joe would always run me into the ground, no respect for his older brother whatsoever, and he'd say, well, you look, there's a key. I put it in the grill, and I said, did you tell Nanette? Absolutely. Yeah, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Well, you know what happened. You know, he never told Nanette. And I'm digging this key out of this charcoal stuff, and I'm just trying to get it in the lock, you know. And Nanette's upstairs locking and loading. She's got the thing drawn when she comes down. And I asked Joe a little later on. I said, you know, Joe, did you forget? He said, oh, yeah, yeah. Then we just moved on. That was the end of that discussion. From now on, when I'm ever anywhere close to Chicago, I call Nanette just to let her know where I'm at. And I pretty much do that hourly until I get back up to Minnesota. I could go on for, you know, as I'm sure all these agents that I've met here have a lot of stories to tell about Joe, but we are in church, so I'll save those for when we get across the street at the Weathermark. If you're not an agent, please ask Jim Martin or some of his buddies that they can fill you in on some of the things that I've actually witnessed, so they're true. But if you are an agent, look up Tom Kennedy, because Tom has been with Joe since first grade, high school, college. In fact, Tom helped Joe and I get through college. Close friend, very close friend. I'm sure we all know how generous both Joe and Nanette were monetarily. And I hope you got some experience in how he was even more generous with his time. I moved away. My daughter came back here, still single. She wouldn't. This is how much she liked her parents. The minute she graduated, she went right back to Chicago. I offered to put a door in the basement. You have your own apartment. She's heading back to Chicago. And Joe would check in on her routinely. And as time goes on, Megan married John, who's here today also. And Megan's, you know, I love my daughter Megan. And I think Megan loves me. She's my only daughter, and she has my only grandson. But I couldn't be more proud of Megan and John for naming that grandson the name they chose. As our parents grew older, you know, I'm gone, I'm states away and all that, it was routine for Joe every weekend, literally every weekend. He'd drive back down to Park Forest and spend quality time with my folks. I mean, and it wasn't just a, you know, a drive-by, check the inventory and all. You know, he'd be taking my father to the Legion. When my father passed away, he'd be taking my mother to the Legion. That's when he got free drinks because everybody liked my mom. Joe benefited from that. I guess I'm not the only one who considers Joe a best friend. I do, and I will continue to miss my brother. Joe loved golf, didn't care much for fishing. I love to fish, and I don't care much for golf. It's a terrible waste of farmland, as far as I'm concerned. My biggest regret in life is that I didn't embrace the game of golf because I missed out on so much time I could have spent with my best friend, Joe. Closing? Are we done? There's a Nanette, we're going to have some entertainment over at the Weathermark, so please join Nanette and the rest of her extended family. There's about 200 of us. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for our brother Joe, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this assembly will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of God's kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you. Lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Joseph in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet again in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
In the sure hope of the resurrection, we take leave of our brother Joseph. Let us go in peace.